I'm the Gadget Guru, Andy Parr, and you're watching TheVog.net. I'm here in Palm Beach Gardens, Florida, at the Marisol Walk Shopping Center, out in front of Serafino's Italian Restaurant, where I had the pleasure of meeting a Vog member who's been around for a while. And the funny thing is, we only live a couple miles from each other, and this is the first time we've had the opportunity of meeting. So welcome, APD Spider. I guess we can call you Cedric.
Cedric, yes.
Okay. Now, I think before we get started, you have a really interesting job. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Sure. I'm a corporate jet pilot here in South Florida for a big company, and I travel all over the world.
And now, I know we've tried to get together a few times in the past, and you typically, you're out for a week, then you come back in. Is that pretty much how your schedule runs?
Pretty much, yeah. I alternate weeks of work where I'm out of town for a week, and then I'm home for a week.
Well, you know, it must be interesting. I don't know if you ever have the ability, since you're flying corporate jets, to take the bike with you on some trips. I don't know if it fits on there.
No, it doesn't fit on the jet, but I have the flexibility of renting motorcycles when I'm out and about in different locations.
Okay. Well, let's take a minute and go through some of the things that you've done with your bike.
Well, it's a 2012 cross country, and I bought it in stock black from Volusia Motorsports up in New Smyrna Beach, and made a few changes to it. Cosmetically, I've added the Arlen Ness flip windshield, Kuryakin mirrors. I put the Vic HID modification to the front headlight. I painted the cowling. I had those painted to match the gloss black. I added the Vic Baggers bag fillers to the back to hide the gap between the saddlebags and the fender. And then more lighting. I've changed as well the tail light with the Custom Dynamics brake light modulator. And
that's the one that when you hit the brake, it will strobe to help get more attention.
That's correct. It has about 10 different strobe patterns to it that you can set yourself. And I also added a Fusion LED light kit to the entire bike. That's my latest project that I did. But performance-wise, I added Lloyd's performance air filter. I have his VFC3 fuel controller installed, and I have the Witch Doctor's unbaffled mufflers with the Witch Doctor contrast cut exhaust tips, and which I think are my favorite part of the bike.
Okay, now before we get finished with this video today, I want to definitely go through, we want to crank up the bike, maybe get a drive by here with the unbaffled Witch Doctor's muffler sound like. But let's start off here. You were talking about your windscreen. You went with the Arlen Ness blade shield, is that correct?
The Arlen Ness flip windshield.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you notice this different than what came stock on your bike?
Well, the only other windshield I rode with was the stock windshield. And although that provided average wind protection for this type of bike, I noticed that the flip add-on to the windshield is about the same height as the stock, but that extra flip probably gives me another 2 or 3 inches of less wind buffeting on the top part of my head, which is just enough for me, and I'm 6 feet tall.
Well, you know, when the cross country first came out, and with the new design forged bars, and when it first shipped, it did have a smaller windshield on it. A lot of people were talking about the buffeting issue, and that it kind of blew you around a little bit. What's your experience on the bike with the wind protection, both upper and lower?
You know, the definition of buffeting to some people varies. For me, if you ride a bike with no windshield, no fairing, you're getting 100% buffeting because you're getting airflow to your entire body. This bike was no different, with the exception that you would get less buffeting, or you know, the feeling of the wind hitting your chest was less on this bike. You would still get some to the face. For me, it was not headache inducing or anything that was you know, a deal breaker when I rode the Victory. But there's obviously some people have done modifications, the lowers have helped, the flip windshields or the Tola windshields help them. But I mean, if you're trying to ride in a enclosed space where you get no wind to your body at all, you know, that's not necessarily buffeting. That's not getting any wind whatsoever. So it was never really an issue for me, but it does help on long rides on the highway reduce the forward pressure on my head from the wind hitting it when I'm on the highway at high speeds.
And you think the flip has helped pull the air up over your head?
It's definitely, yes, it has, but it's definitely not the solution if you do mostly highway riding. But if you're doing, 55 miles an hour or less type of riding throughout town or back roads, it's enough for me, yeah.
Okay. Now, the mirrors, I noticed you went with the Ness mirrors. I think it's a great look. How are they visibility-wise?
The visibility is reduced from the stock, but they're not the Ness mirrors. They look like the Ness mirrors, but they're actually from Kuryakin. I think they're called the Skith mirrors. The visibility is smaller, but the good news is that there's no vibration still when I ride on the bike. It's not like some aftermarket mirrors that vibrate loose and you can't see out of them. So these are pretty good. They're not that bad for visibility.
So up here, I noticed you have your Ramball mount up here. What usually goes on there?
It's usually my iPhone. I have a universal adapter that clips onto the iPhone, and I charge it when I'm on long rides so that I can stream music to it, to my Bluetooth helmet, and use the GPS for it too as well.
Did you put the iPod cable on your bike?
No.
Okay, so basically when you're using your iPhone, you're just syncing it via Bluetooth to your headset. Which headset are you using?
Right now I have a Nolan N103 helmet with the Nolan NCOM system. I've had it for about 6 years now, so it's time for me to upgrade to something else, and I'm currently in the market shopping for a new helmet. But I didn't integrate the iPod to the radio of this motorcycle because I decided to use wirelessly to my helmet. I use the FM radio on this bike by itself, and then if I'm on long trips and I wear my Bluetooth helmet, I'll stream the music wirelessly.
Okay, now maybe it's my memory, but I noticed that you have the monochrome tank badges on your bike. That's not the badge that came with this bike, is it?
No, these are the victory badges that are for the 10th anniversary edition motorcycle. So I'm lying with the, I'm taking the honor away from the guys that have the 10th anniversary edition, but I thought black and chrome looked really nice on this motorcycle, and I think since this is the original badging on those bikes, it looks better than some of the aftermarket stickers that you replace the stock emblem with.
I remember, I believe it was 2009 when Victory came out with the monochrome tank badge. If I remember the quote they said, and I could be incorrect on this, I believe back then they said that monochrome was going to be their tank badge color for their second generation or for their second decade of bikes. But it only lasted a year or so, then they went back to the color. But I notice, with your bike being a black and chrome theme, it really fits in well.
Thank you. I agree, and I hope nobody else copies my design, my thoughts. But I've seen other victories with them, and they do look great. And they have come up with some different badging nowadays, and it's just a matter of time before they take their new red V emblem and turn that into a black and chrome one as well. I think that would look nice too.
You know, there's a lot of people out there making badges, and I'm sure at some point that they'll come up. Now, before we started, you were showing me your bag fillers back here. It really makes a good look on the bike. How difficult were they to install?
They were not difficult at all. If you've removed your saddlebags before, you can install these in minutes. I was talking to Vic Baggers when I installed them to verify that I wasn't going to misplace them and scratch the bags or the fender, and it's a simple snap in place kind of instruction, and you really can't screw it up.
Okay, for people who might be considering cross country, I notice you have your trunk off today. How would you compare the ride with and without the trunk, whether you're riding solo or with a passenger?
Riding solo with the trunk adds some higher center of gravity weight to it. So when you start leaning, you notice that the bike leans easier into the turns because of that top weight. It's really not significantly different off the line, acceleration-wise. There's some added weight, but it's really not all that bad. If you're riding two up with the trunk, I think it helps because first of all, the passenger is a lot more comfortable, but center of gravity, the passenger has a tendency to add weight lower to the seat to offset the tall or the heavy weight on the higher tour pack. So I think it's easier to ride with a passenger and the tour pack than it is single with the tour pack.
What advice would you give to somebody who right now might be considering a cross country and possibly or quite probably comparing it to other bikes? What recommendations or advice would you give to somebody? What questions should they ask before buying, and what recommendations would you give?
Well, the best thing you can do is test drive. You have to go to your competitor's dealership and see if they can give you the same level of service that Victory has given me. Test drive the bike like you would ride it if it was yours. Really look at the value that you get, and the old stereotypes that the Victories are not customizable, that there's not enough options out there. I strongly disagree. Throughout the years, there's been so many vendors that have come up and created great products for these motorcycles that it really is apples to apples now when you're shopping with other brands. And I really think that the value that you get from the 106 engine, the transmission, the reliability, and the performance, and the stability of the ride is second to none with Victory.
Okay, well, you've already done a lot of mods to your bike. Anything else on the wish list for the time being?
If money was no object, for the time being, the last edition was the LED light kit, and if it was nighttime, you could see it. It's beautiful, no major work. I'm not gonna put 8 bars on there just because of the comfort of the stock handlebars. For me, it's just perfect. I would love to put a 23-inch wheel in the front. The cost associated with that is too much, but if money was...
Once you do that, then you have a lot of other mods that follow it, right?
That's correct. The triple trees have to change, the forks, the fender, the wheel. And then I've done that once before to an old motorcycle, and once I changed the front end, it didn't ride the same, and that's what I'm afraid of, is I don't want to jeopardize the comfort, the ride, the stability of the Victory Cross Country.
Okay, so the factory's listening right now. If you could change one thing about your bike coming from the factory, what would you have the factory do different that they didn't do on your bike from stock?
That's a great question. The extended warranties, I think they should be standard, being that they sell such a reliable product, it shouldn't really matter. But I would like to see more options from the get-go when you customize or order your motorcycle. And I know they've started doing that, but I'd love to see the capability of choosing different fork colors for the front end. They sell the black ones on different Victory models. I would like to see that an option for a black stock bike with the black forks. Or if you want the black bike with the aluminum colored forks, you can have that as well. So a little bit more factory options to not just color type specific options, but if you want to mix and match, I'd like to have that ability from the factory.
Okay, I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a short break, but when we come back, as promised, we're going to take a listen to the Witch Doctor's Unbaffled Exhaust. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. And we're back with APD Spider, and as promised, we want to talk about your exhaust. Now, which exhaust system did you go with for your bike?
The Unbaffled mufflers from Witch Doctors.
Did you have to do any fuel management or anything else when you added the pipe?
No, initially I did not. Initially I just put the pipes, and the bike ran. It ran fine. It was a little rich, so there was some smell of unburned fuel, but it ran fine. But I did add the Lloyd's VFC3 fuel controller to it. That was installed by Scott down at Conquest Customs. And then I added the Lloyd's air performance air filter for the cross country crossroads bikes.
Okay, to help out others who might be considering doing the same, what differences did you notice once you added those?
Initially, when I added the unbaffled mufflers, I lost power. You can tell there's nothing restricting the airflow, so there's a loss of horsepower and torque. Is it noticeable? slightly. But, you know, this bike is so powerful already as it is that it was worth the noise upgrade for me and the loss of power. But as my bank account replenished, I added some more performance factors to it, the controller and the air filter, and the performance loss came back. And then this 2 weeks ago at Bike Week 2013, I had the bike dyno-tuned by KMC Power Sports. And Kyle from KMC, who's a Lloyd's certified mechanic, has taken over Lloyd's mobile dyno tuning unit. And he tweaked it so that it's running perfect now at all ranges. And it actually produced 104 foot-pounds of torque.
Now, you said you have the Witch Doctor's unbaffled exhaust. Now, I've heard different reviews. I've heard some people say, you know, go with the baffled. They still sound great, and they won't give you the drone at highway speeds. And then you have others that say, no, go with the unbaffled. What's your opinion of riding with the unbaffled, both in town and on the highway?
You're not going to ask me which motor oil I'm using next, are you?
We're going to save that question for the forum.
Listen, baffled, unbaffled, all the different exhaust types, it's all a personal preference. In the end, it's how much noise do you want it to make. The unbaffled mufflers are going to be the loudest ones you can get. In my opinion, I believe that's a fact.
Do you have any, I mean, of course, you know, and we'll hear in a moment, it sounds great. Any negative issues we should know about?
Of course, when you're unbaffling or an exhaust, you're removing back pressure, and by removing back pressure, you're going to get backfiring. You're going to get some sputtering at times, but it's still manageable. And I don't want to get into whether or not you're voiding any warranties, but as far as I'm concerned, it's a personal choice that you have to make, and there's a lot of options for victories, and I wanted the loudest I could get.
Well, speaking of that, why don't I step back for a minute, and I'm going to put the microphone down. Let's see what it sounds like. You ready?
Ready.
You know, I have a feeling that they're going to hear you coming on that bike. You know, it sounds really good. Any final words of wisdom, anybody who might be considering a Victory Cross Country?
Absolutely. Ride, test drive, and you will see that you will love this bike. It's my favorite bike that I've owned thus far. And, you know, it's still an American machine. It's got its personality traits. But it's what keeps us in the game, you know, tweaking our bikes and riding them. And this is the most comfortable bike I've ever ridden thus far. And I used to own a 2009 Goldwing, which for me, I found the Goldwing was too upright and too mid-control foot settings. It just was not a comfortable ride for long distance, even though that's the reason that bike was built. I find this bike with the floorboards, the settings, the handlebar, everything is perfect for me. It is the most comfortable bike that I've had. So go out and ride one and you'll buy one.
APD Spidermonte, it's a pleasure meeting you. We just lived down the street, so hopefully we can get together again. It was, again, my pleasure. Thank you so much for your time, and as always say, ride safely.
Thank you.
For the VOG.net, I'm the gadget guru Andy Parr, and I'll see you on the road and online.